Welcome to Infinite Pixels. I'm Bear. The crew is back in the boys are back in town. And I've got, of course, two of my favorite gentlemen here with me.
Hello.
Again, they are
Zach
and
it's Kenny.
The master of disaster.
Kenny, the king of space drink.
The king of space drinks.
Space drinks.
Space drinks.
Space drinks.
All of multiple them. Space drinks at all once. And today we are playing. Hold on. Fuck you.
Pac-Man!
We're playing Pac-Man. Pac-Man Tournament Championship Edition. Who wants to play this?
I haven't played.
I don't want to play this.
Okay. I haven't played a real video game.
You're crazy, man.
Maybe.
I mean, I'll play it.
But. 4 weeks.
Jesus Christ. What? You haven't been playing Legion?
Yeah, I've been playing. I'm playing shit out of Legion.
That's a real video game.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. That's a real video game. So I actually hate it. I don't like World of Warcraft anymore. I am done with it.
You are done?
Done.
I did not
finish the storyline.
I called that.
You're not anything. Done. You're you not did done. Call that. Yeah. I'm done, dude. Done. I don't
you're
like it.
Done. No one's done. Look, that's the thing about World of Warcraft. You're not ever done.
That's what everybody always says.
Oh my God.
Can you bomb jump? What's bomb jumping?
If you hit A at any time.
Oh my God, it's just like continuous.
Continuous. This is awesome. Yeah,
it's 5 minutes.
Get that fucking fruit. What are you doing?
Oh my God, I'm stressing.
He's getting all the pellets.
I'm stressing.
Dog, get the fruit.
I'm stressing.
He's getting all the pellets. You gotta get more bombs and shit.
Oh my God.
Oh, so you have to get all the pellets before the fruit?
What's this thing
the fruit ends
there?
A level?
Hey. Boom. Oh, yeah. That's cool.
You
can
shit.
End the level early, but you lose out on points from pellets.
Okay.
I can't lose out on the pellets, man. I need them pellets. It's like crack rocks, man.
Okay. Yeah, they in fact
basically,
are crack rocks.
Yeah, I mean,
what is it? They're like
I'm freaking out. I gotta get.
Yeah, you can go to the next one.
I'm fucking leaving.
If you ever need to get away, press A.
Press A. Well, usually I need to get away.
That's what the bomb jump is.
Oh,
yeah,
that's
what the bomb jump.
Oh Jesus! Oh,
now keep in mind, you can bump into them a few times before they get pissy at you.
Oh yeah.
And they won't kill you automatically.
Sounds like Mike's girlfriend.
They won't kill you. She won't kill you automatically.
Not automatically.
That sounds awful. That sounds like an awful relationship. I'm glad you got out of that.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. Oh my God. All right. I don't know. Okay, so now it's a lot of them?
So are you supposed to eat those?
No. You just go past them and they start following the red.
Oh, so you don't have to actually.
Yeah, you don't have to actually touch them. Gotcha. You're not actually supposed to touch them.
Oh, what does it do if you touch them?
Nothing.
Oh my God. Jesus Christ.
Nothing bad happens, but you haven't gotten enough yet.
It's so many of them.
Kenny's like, fuck this.
So the pellet won't show up or the fruit won't show up until you eat a certain amount of dots. But
okay.
You don't have to
okay.
eat every dot on the level.
Gotcha.
See, now it popped up.
Now it popped up. Got it. See, I just went right to it.
Now.
Oh my God.
But you can bomb jump to it, right?
That's what is this?
Yeah, you can bomb jump to it.
Oh, what the hell is this noise?
What is this?
Follow that line that he's going on.
That he's going. Oh, yeah. Okay, I see.
Just turn. No, not. No, hit into him.
Oh, hit into him.
Yeah. Well, now you can't.
Oh, shit. What happened?
He went away.
No, man, it's not cool.
Well, you got all the things.
That is not allowed in today's society. That guy didn't get high.
So, yeah, this plays a little different than your usual Pac-Man.
Yeah.
Oh, just a little bit. There's no, like, it's not different at all, really.
Oh, my God. Oh, it's not them.
There's still mazes. There's still ghosts. You know, it's not like.
There's still banana peels and stuff?
Fuck this. This game is stupid. I hate it.
This game's dumb.
It's all right. We can't monetize this now, though, because I said fuck.
That's all right. It happens. Why is he so fast?
Because I don't know if you guys have been paying attention to the YouTube thing, but like they're like going ham on.
Yeah, people are pissed.
Yeah. They're going ham on demonetizing videos for saying things like the F word and.
Ah, fuck it.
And. Or like doing like stuff like. Like teaching about controversial subjects, like,
or if you show anything that could be controversial, such as
yeah,
war?
Like even like explaining it, like things like in like news style casts,
yeah,
like
ridiculous.
That's it's
holy Jesus, oh my God,
that's I mean it, to me that's fucking
oh
stupid.
My God,
see this is Seizure City,
oh my yeah I'm if we split this in a dark room I'd be dead right now.
Do you take?
Fuck.
Do you seize?
No, I don't at all, but I figured...
but this would make
this me. Would make me do it. Oh my God.
Are you epileptic and we're playing like a neon game with a bunch of blinking lights?
What are you guys doing playing F-Zero in the dark?
Oh, God.
All right, now go get the pellet.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, I'm stressing. All right, so I follow him?
No, you want to hit the biggest ghost.
In the middle?
No, in the front.
Oh, gotcha. Oh, because it would collect them all. Okay.
Yeah. He's gonna keep running away from you.
No.
There you go.
Oh shit!
Yeah. That's tough.
Okay, so that was tight.
That was tough, man.
That was.
Yeah,
that
I
was
like
cool.
It.
All right.
Okay.
The AI actually makes it to where it runs away from you. Geez.
So it's not like Billy, whatever his name is.
So yeah. I get it. You build up all the little ghosts behind him, so it wrecks your score up. Got it. Got
yep.
it. Got it. Got it.
That's cool.
Okay, that makes sense.
I don't.
This game is better than any other game I ever played in my life.
That's what?
Yep. Oh my god.
Have you played video games?
You heard it, Namco.
Oh my god.
Sponsor us.
Yeah.
Do it now.
This game is awesome. It is the best game
ever.
This
is the greatest game ever. It makes me want to punch small children in the mouth.
You don't even have to sponsor us, Namco. You can just give us money for Extra Life, honestly.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Is it up?
Give us a bunch of money for Extra Life.
Yeah, the key.
Okay.
The
maybe you'll win a PS4
you can
Pro.
Hit the A.
Yeah.
Bounce
we didn't announce
plug.
That.
Shameless plug.
No.
Oh my god.
Maybe we should wait.
Yeah, we should wait.
Oh my god.
Until we have enough money to get it.
Until we actually have the
PS4 Pro.
Yeah. That'd be
done.
The best idea.
What's the countdown? What's happening? What's happening?
Do you want to do a PS4 Pro or do you want to do an Xbox One S?
I think the PS4 would be the better move.
Oh.
Why do you think that?
Huh?
Why do you think that?
Just because it's more popular of the two.
You think the Pro is more popular than the S right now?
Yeah.
Okay, so we can talk about this. Because
also
this is,
because the S won't even be out.
We might correct. Not. The S is out.
S is out.
Or no, the Scorpio.
Yeah,
the
Scorpio. Scorpio.
Yeah, you're thinking
Scorpio.
About Scorpio.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's been out for months now. So.
What's happening?
So we don't know. We're going to try and get some cool stuff for the Extra Life stream. We're going to have an Extra Life stream. We're going to try and get some cool stuff for to give away. Sure. I've already got a bunch of games, PC games that Steam keys and stuff that I'm going to give away to people that donate.
Yeah.
We're going to give away at least one an hour, and then we're going to try and get some really cool big stuff too. Whether that's a console, a PC, a graphics card, whatever, we don't know yet. Or it could be nothing because we might just not do anything.
You guys might not get anything.
We don't
I'm going to keep it.
Yeah, we don't have a lot of money, so.
This is what I'm going to do. This is what we're going to
we
do.
We don't make
the,
any money, so.
No, this is what we're going to do for the Extra Life.
We're
going to give everybody.
What are you looking at? That's the camera.
Let him go. Why would you do that? Why would you not let him do that?
This is what we're going to do.
This is what we're going to do, yo. Oh, that was close. I'm sorry. I apologize. I forgot what you thought. Oh, poop.
Way to go, Bear.
I fucked it up.
That's fine.
No, well, like we're gonna try and get some cool big cool stuff too for people that donate a decent amount of money that we can give away. So
because it's all about the children,
it's all about the children. Yep,
it's true.
Yeah,
you know what else would be cool if you guys made your Extra Life accounts.
Oh yeah,
we
should definitely
have like a
do
month.
That. Yeah, we should definitely.
You
do that.
Have a month, but you should be fundraising now.
Prior
to
I've,
the stream,
I've been fundraising. I've been
have
doing
you?
I've been doing tons of stuff. I've been
kissing babies.
None of that.
Yep.
One thing I have been doing, which has nothing to do with Extra Life at all, is drinking my life away. So I've been doing that pretty, recently and frequently.
I've been getting shit my pants drunk. That's what I've been doing.
I don't know about you guys, but I poop myself when I drink. But
man, I'm glad I don't drink. I'm real glad.
Yeah, don't do it. It's terrible for you.
No, it's funny for me. I poop myself less when I'm drunk.
Yeah.
Nope.
Got that irritable bowel.
Oh, I'm telling you, man, it's rough. It's rough out of here. This game is trippy, man.
Yeah,
it is. Crap. So we're gonna be doing an Extra Life stream though, and that's gonna be cool. You should tune in.
I think it'll be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. It's gonna be 24 hours. I know Zach and I are gonna be here for most of it. I'm probably gonna be here for almost all of it.
I will definitely
because you live here.
Yeah, I do live where we record. So I'm gonna. I mean, I'm probably gonna take some naps because 24 hours is a long time to stay up.
Well, I can play. Well,
how long?
Me and Zach, we've kind of planned something out for whenever y'all do. Y'all need an admission? Boom! I play Warcraft.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, you damn right. Because I could play that forever.
Ugh.
Don't at me.
Ugh.
Don't do things like that.
Ugh.
Don't do that.
I mean, I can. I'm just, ugh. No, that's fine.
Oh, my. Oh, wow.
What is this?
What is this?
What is this? This is horse shit. What did you, is this an Adam Sandler, like? This is an Adam Sandler thing.
Isn't this that movie Pixels?
Yeah, this looks like that movie Pixels.
Yeah, oh, my. Jesus Christ. Latter-day Saints.
That movie was not good.
It wasn't?
Why would you watch that?
It looked cool. Because I watch dumb movies.
I thought it was
all the time. Yeah, you just I watch really bad
sitcoms all the time too. So, like, I'm like really into The Big Bang Theory.
I've never watched that show.
It's not good.
It's not
really. I have no reason.
I still watch it.
People
it's not good.
Exaggerate how bad it is.
Yeah,
it's also not good.
Yeah, no, it's the epitome of like
crappy sitcom.
Yeah, shitty sitcom. Yeah,
I miss
like,
Seinfeld.
All the tropes and stuff like that.
Seinfeld's not a shitty sitcom.
I didn't really like Seinfeld, though.
Yeah, what is wrong with you?
I didn't get it.
What?
Honestly.
What do you mean not to get? What is?
Get the most common and average comedy.
Exactly. It's not the most common and average
it
comedy.
It totally is.
It's not.
They had a whole episode around like not being able to set your clock.
And it was so good.
They were all insanely neurotic.
Yeah.
It was great, though.
But what they
neurotic.
Were dealing with...
Oh, okay.
Well, what they were dealing with was common stuff.
Yeah.
And it's funny because they don't know how to deal with it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And there were so many episodes that was just great. Like, you can... I mean, you could just mention, like, headliner, Soup Nazi, Marble Rye. Like, you just,
Marble Rye.
I mean, they kind of invented, like, the real...
Awesome.
They kind of, like, invented or pioneered the bottle episode, too.
Absolutely.
The what?
They did...
The bottle episode when they did the parking garage thing.
Yeah.
I've watched a lot of fucking Seinfeld, you guys. Okay, so I should kind of rephrase that. I always kind of like do for comedic effect that I don't like Seinfeld at all. I've watched a shit ton of Seinfeld.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not that I don't like it. It's just that I think it's like super overrated.
No, you're crazy.
Yeah, I don't think it's as good as a lot of people say it is, but I do think it's. I mean, obviously, I've watched a lot of it, so I think it's good enough to watch a lot of.
Fair. Here's a rebuttal. Yes, what? It is. Okay. It's as good as everybody says.
It's not as good as everybody says.
It is,
it's better. It's better than what everyone says.
It's so
no,
funny.
that's ridiculous because because people talk about that thing, that show, like it's like, I don't know,
Soup
some
Nazi
kind of.
Great.
I mean, Soup Nazi was a good episode.
Hey, Buck Showalter was on an episode.
That's true.
Yeah, because he was
manager
the Yankees.
Yankees.
Yeah, Even
I
really hope we can give him a championship.
Man,
we won't. But
I know.
Look. If you want to talk the baseball, let's talk the baseball.
Bear, you want to try?
Yeah, I'll try.
You
hey, man.
Try video
Whatever
games?
You do, don't stare too hard, because it will hurt.
What's an easy one?
Everything on the bottom row.
Yeah.
All
right. Yeah, hexagon. That sounds about right.
That's great. Let's do this. Hexagon. Just, okay.
Yeah, you can set, like, what the ghost looks like, what the background is, the music and stuff. There's, like, a bunch of remixes.
Remix.
I love this drum and bass. What you kids call it? Dubstep.
Oh, wait, what the fuck?
Oh, you skipped.
Yeah, man.
Whoa, okay. I thought it was at like the bottom.
Nah. No.
It's just in different areas.
It's always generally in the same place. It just depends on the map.
Did I die? Yeah. I'm the first one to die, aren't I?
No, I died.
Oh, you died?
Die.
Okay.
Because I'm a champ.
You are a champ.
But I also played a harder level.
Yeah, you played a much harder
excuses.
Level.
Oh, hey.
Got them bombs. Oh, shit.
Oh, access denied.
Right? Oh, God. Stupid as fuck.
Also, you can press X and just halt if you'd like.
Halt?
Yeah, like not move. Like if you're going down that and like a ghost is coming towards you and you think he's going to turn...
You just stop,
Just stop if you'd like.
Yeah, everyone gets into the pool. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Yep.
What do you go, Super Saiyan? Why is it glowing?
Who?
Pac-Man.
Oh, that's just like an indicator so you don't get lost.
Oh.
Got them all.
Looks like you want like Super Saiyan.
Oh, jump. Okay, that's how I bombed up. Okay, cool. Oh, power up. Oh, I gotta kill him. Gonna murder him.
I must murder the
now
ghost.
Now you have to get the fruit there.
Oh. Don't stop following me, dog. What are you, some kind of ghost that needs to kill Pac-Man? Or some shit?
Kind of demented shit is this?
Kind of surprised they don't put Miss Pac-Man anywhere in here.
Miss Pac-Man was the shit.
She's probably on the corner.
Oh. Okay.
Let's all pretend like we didn't know she was gonna go there. It's all that.
Oh shit!
Hey.
You got it.
Boom.
All right, you're about halfway through.
halfway through.
Yeah. It's all time-based.
Oh, I see. Okay, yeah. I see.
Oh, it's time-based.
Yeah, it's a score attack type of thing.
Ah.
So you just try and beat your score and get the best grade. And he's going to be pissed. He's going to chase you.
Why is he so pissed?
Because you hit into him too many times.
Oh, shit.
He's so angry.
You did it again.
It's actually...
Get the fuck out of here.
It's actually really cool.
Yeah, I mean, everybody loved the first one.
Power pellet, what up?
And,
get out of here.
This one plays really different.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting that.
For a Pac-Man game, to say that a Pac-Man game plays different, that's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of glad they didn't just do the same thing.
Right.
Because I went into it just assuming it would be just... I loved the first one so much that I bought it without looking anything up. And I was like...
I wish I said I played Pac-Man a lot. I played Dr. Mario probably a lot more.
I played a lot of...
Dr. Mario was my joint.
I played a lot of actually... what is it? Not Dr. Mario. Because fuck that game. No, I played a lot of Ms. Pac-Man, actually. My friend had it for the Genesis, and we ended up playing a shit ton of it for some reason or another.
Ms. Pac-Man's actually
Yeah, but like this is like in the age of like... We're also like super young, like...
What do you mean?
We're like 9.
Oh, at that time.
Yeah, like we were super young and like freaking out. Freaking the fuck out. We were super young and like it was just kind of weird for dudes so young to be like super into like Ms. Pac-Man.
Why?
At this
That was like the, you know, that
well,
was
like
the
you had like altered it was Genesis and so like we had like Altered Beasts and all the bloody stuff and things like that.
Yeah.
Primal Rage.
But it's
Primal Rage was a thing. Primal Rage was an awful fighting game.
It was so much
like,
fun.
But like, yeah, because you're like, oh, I'm a dinosaur. Look at me.
I can fight this guy.
That's great. Uh-oh. I love Primal Rage.
This guy's mad as fuck. Get out my house, dog.
You got 30 seconds. Get that pellet.
Boom. Give me fucking. Yeah.
Look at all that.
So much.
All them yums.
So hard.
If you get that, yeah, you got a one up.
Hell yeah. All right, so I've got. What, 11 seconds now?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just time attack. That's fine.
Yep.
Go ahead and try and...
But all those... on that menu, they're just a bunch of different types of boards and stuff like that.
Nice.
So you get to time attack, like, a bunch of different...
Oh, that's cool.
...stuff. So it's not exactly that's the cool. same.
I've never been, like, a big, like... Like, high score chaser.
Yeah, no.
Personally.
See, that's what I grew up on.
Yeah, no, I mean, like, a lot of the games that I played... were like that, but like for some reason, like I never cared as much about high scores, except in arcades where I could put ass for everyone to see.
Yeah, exit. That should unlock like in one or two. Or yeah, go back.
No, I wasn't really big on time attack either. Same thing when you play fighting games. It's like, oh, you got to like the survival in fighting games. I didn't care about that shit either.
I like that too.
I wasn't good enough. Highway.
I'm not good at it, but I like doing it.
Yeah, I was always really bad at it. I felt like I'm not like the best in the world. So like, fuck this.
I would always give it a shot.
If I couldn't beat the developer's scores, I just got pissed at it.
No. You could always beat the developer's score, man.
Yeah.
I couldn't.
That was the easiest part, because developers usually suck at their own game unless they're Ed Boon.
Well, no, like, they weren't necessarily, like, developer's score. Like, the ones that the developers put in.
Gotcha.
Hey, man.
I'm sure the developers did a lot more than that. Hey, dude, what's up?
He's pissed already.
What are you doing? Oh, man. We're playing Pac-Man Championship Edition.
Yeah.
Here at
you want to run after Kenny?
Yeah, you can run one in.
I was never much of a Pac-Man guy.
Am I the only Pac-Man guy here?
Yeah, you might be.
Really?
Like I said, I played a lot of Ms. Pac-Man, but it wasn't for high scores. It was just to see how many levels you could get through. And then
people played for the high score?
Oh, yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was like the thing. That's like the reason to play Pac-Man.
Well, no, the reason to play Pac-Man is to get to the last board.
If there was a last board.
Yeah, right.
I mean, it glitched.
There
it
is. It glitches out.
Really?
Yeah.
Billy, what's his name? Billy Mitchell.
Like there's
the Hot Sauce King.
Yeah, there's a level cap, like a score cap actually. That if you have a perfect game, the game just bugs out at a point.
Really?
Yeah.
I
there's
never
no
knew
like
that.
End.
Yeah, basically it's not an actual end to the game. It's basically like nobody's ever gonna get here, so we're gonna this is where the logic breaks down in the program.
In the program. Yeah. Well, that's stupid.
I mean, that's a big deal, breaking a program that was thought to be totally endless.
Yeah.
But he's also, like, apparently, like, a giant douchebag, so.
I wouldn't doubt it. Is that Brian Mitchell?
Billy Mitchell. Okay. Yeah. Hot Toss King.
Billy Mitchell. Where's America Ties?
Oh, that sounds about right. He's going to make it great again? Oh, I should have said that. Oh.
He's not. He's just going to try to sell his hot sauce off of his Pac Man fame. But people have actually beaten it in quicker time than him
now. Yeah. Really? Steve Wiebe. There's a whole documentary about it.
Really?
Yeah, it's actually really good.
There's a whole documentary about.
Well, it was King Kong.
Yeah.
Or, I mean,
because he had a couple Donkey of Kong. Records. Yeah. King of Kong, I think.
Yeah, but the game was Donkey Kong.
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, because he had a couple records. He had Donkey Kong, Pac-Man. Yeah. Couple other things.
But yeah, for a while.
I'm pretty sure they've all since been broken.
They had to.
He actually got it back.
Oh, did he?
Yeah,
did he?
In Pac-Man, I think. It keeps going back and forth between people. I actually got really interested in like how they keep track of all that.
Yeah, do they have like Guinness style world record like people? Like they're like.
Yeah, it's there's a
like I'm going to this thing.
In Jersey.
That, oh really?
Yeah.
They're like the official.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
You don't have to go there to do it, I don't think, but that's, like, the basis of where all the scores are. Like, that's where you send your video.
Oh, okay. So they're, like, record keepers.
Yeah.
Okay. That makes sense.
Like, a lot of that documentary is in that arcade.
That makes sense. Is it, like an arcade, like, on the shore or something like that?
No, I think it's just on, like, some suburban area.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Get him.
Because there get definitely him. Wasn't any, like, water.
Get him, Adam Sandler.
Yeah. Boom. Cut him off, boy.
Because it kind of reminds me of, like a shore-style, like...
Yeah, you'd think.
Yeah.
Oh, what you the did. Shit?
You
died.
Dead.
You died.
Oh, there's another Pac-Man. Get that
life.
Yeah. There you go. It's like you never died.
Yep.
Yeah, I never died.
Just called me Pierce Brosnan because tomorrow never dies.
You don't actually have to hit them. You just have to run by them. You know that, right?
Really?
Yeah, you don't have to ever. It's actually better if you don't run into them.
Because you don't waste any time.
Shit.
Apparently, like, there's specific moves. I don't know. Jeff Gerstmann said that there are specific moves in the that are tough to pull off. Because the controls aren't as tight in this game.
Yeah, like if you take corners at the right time, you can boost your speed.
Yeah.
And it's pretty tough to do. And it does seem like it's harder to do than in Championship Edition 1.
I think that's what he was complaining about in the review thing that he did. It wasn't really a review. It was just kind of like...
He was just talking about it.
I mean, I can agree
that it doesn't feel as tight, yeah. But it also is doing things that I have never seen Pac-Man do. So I kind of forgive it for not being as tight.
Okay, I can see that.
And I haven't played enough of it to say that it's better than the first one,
mm-hmm.
But I have played enough of it to say that I enjoy it.
It's
actually pretty fun to play.
Yeah, it's fun to play.
And it's a nice twist on something that I've been playing for like 20 years.
No, for a Pac-Man game, I definitely enjoy.
I mean, you've been playing for 20 years because that's how old you were.
Oh my God.
You are. I mean,
pretty much.
So Kenny like and I are more like...
Man, 25? I'm about 47.
You're not 47
years old. I wear some Air Moses.
You are not 47 years old, Kenny.
I'm pretty old, man. I just look good
Air
for
Moses
my age.
You're a year
sandals.
Older than I am.
I'm pretty good for my age, man. I ain't gonna front. It was this morning I woke up. I
look pretty good for my age.
I woke up this morning and my hip was hurting.
Oof.
I was like, God damn. I didn't even do nothing last night.
My foot's been hurting every morning for the past like 3 months.
Yeah, man.
It sucks.
I've come to
it also might just be because I'm real fat.
Well, it's, hey,
yeah, my feet hurt too.
I've come to the understanding that well, your back hurts because you're just old, or your hip hurts because you're just old. You know, if you eat healthy at this point, you might not get cancer, but
you'll probably still get cancer.
Old. Everybody gets cancer. That's
no,
how people
well,
die.
I mean, hey, look,
that's how pretty much everybody in my family dies.
Oh shit. I mean, the only cancer I get, I think I would
hey,
get
honey,
is
I love you.
The work cancer where I have to go to work every day. I think that's the only cancer I have.
That's the worst kind
that's
of cancer.
That's just work.
Yeah.
That's life in America.
that's not cancer? It's,
work is cancer.
Yeah.
Work is cancer.
Yeah.
So, Oh, well. Watch a bunch of our videos so we don't have to go to work.
Yeah.
Yo, do me the solid and just support my mixtape. I got mixtape.
Oh, my God. You're not walking up to people in the corner, Kenny.
No, it's
you
actually...
You look like you like music.
Yeah. Hey, it looks like you like hip-hop and that rap music.
You want to listen to this CD? All right, yeah, I'll listen to it. All right. Here it is, $5.
Yeah, garbage mixtape.
Oh, no.
Gotta respect the hustle, though.
No.
Gotta respect the hustle. What are you doing? What did you have happen there?
The controller.
Oh, the controller fucked up?
Yeah.
That's lame.
There we go. Yeah, it's back.
Okay. It was probably the funniest thing that happened to me the other night. I was actually walking around downtown, and... Yep. In the process of walking somewhere to get something to eat, this guy stops me. He's like, yo, man, you should definitely check my movement out. Got a mixtape the whole night. I'm like, oh, that's cool, man. I was like, but I apologize. I don't have any cash. He was like, oh, no, it's cool, man. I got that Square chip. And he, like, plugs it into his phone. I'm like, man, no thanks. I'm all right. No thanks, man. Good luck on your movement.
You know how many people he fucking gets with that.
Yeah.
You know how many people he fucking gets with that. Because, like you, the people that, like... That are like, oh man, sorry, I don't have any cash, and then he's like, I have that Square chip, and then they're too embarrassed.
They're too embarrassed to say no. I just kept walking like, oh my god, I'm gonna get some cops. Just walk fast and keep.
I feel like that goes against selling things on the street.
What's up?
I feel like that goes against selling shit on the street.
It does. It completely ruins.
Like if he did that, I'd be like, yeah, I don't. You seem like you. This is fake.
That's because it is.
It's probably a really shitty mixtape.
It's probably terrible. And the main reason why I knew it was probably going to be bad. He said it has 32 songs on it. No thanks.
Like that means he bought a bunch of beats off of YouTube or stole a bunch of beats off of YouTube and then rapped shitty lyrics to it with no flow because there's never any flow.
It never works out. It's like goddamn.
Like I can even appreciate like if it's like. A good flow with like I'm not like a major rap connoisseur, but like I like music a lot.
Absolutely.
So
you're a cockasaur.
That's a dinosaur though.
Yeah.
So like I can appreciate like a good like
good music
like a, good like music. Good rhythm and good music in general, especially somebody that's out there hustling.
Oh yeah.
But like
I told him I was like, man, good luck.
Yeah, but like half. I'll be totally honest with you. $10?
Yeah, man.
The fuck was charging $10 for a mixtape?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, right.
Nah.
That's a Chipotle burrito. That's
more than a Chipotle burrito. That's a Chipotle burrito and
chips.
Guac on the side, yeah.
Chips.
Chips. I will say this.
Are you Homer?
I will say this. I'm getting like a whole bunch of like crazy experiences now that I'm back into the city, which I'm not really like upset or mad about. I just think it's funny. Like, all the crazy shit that's happening now that I'm back in the city.
Go on.
So, like, the other day, I was leaving my apartment. Fuck.
There we go.
And,
this girl just started having sex with
you. No.
And then a guy high-fived you and gave you a beer.
Well, that did happen.
I know that happened.
That was weird.
That did happen.
We were there.
Yeah, you guys were there.
Hey, you want this beer?
Yeah, man. Long time no see, Kenny. How you been? I'm great. Here's a beer.
We're in the middle of a park.
That works.
We told that story before, though.
No, but I was leaving my apartment, and I go to McDonald's because that's like, you know, the place to be in the morning because sausage biscuit with egg is the best thing ever. But in the process of me doing it, this dude walked up and was like, yo, man, I got that kush on the low. He's like, I got nickels on the dimes.
Why doesn't anybody ever offer me drugs in the city anymore?
Then he's like, yo, I got some socks.
Because you don't go to McDonald's.
I got a Raven shirt.
Sometimes I do go to McDonald's for lunch.
Oh, not the right McDonald's.
Not the right McDonald's.
I bet it's the same goddamn McDonald's you go to because it's right by. It's in the same place.
It's in the same place, yeah.
Because you live 2 blocks from where that McDonald's is. I know which one you're talking about.
Then, in the process of all that, my man put on his McDonald's shirt and went to work. And I was like,
oh, shit.
This is awesome. And Danny held the door open for me. I was like, this dude is great. It's the best customer service skills I've ever had. That's I've ever hilarious. Ever experienced in my life. This guy is great.
You want some kush? Because he's working that McDonald's sales tactic.
Oh, yeah.
Because you smoke, then you get the munchies, and
then you buy
a 20-piece nugget instead of a 10-piece.
And he's clearly, working that. Please, there's no shame because he's going to work right there.
Yeah, so he's like, also, do you want that 20-piece nugget?
You want that 20-piece, man.
Instead of that 10-piece. What up?
I think 10-piece are cheap as hell now. Yeah, I knew
like,
something.
They're like 2-something, I think.
Yeah, I knew something was wrong when I saw the Burger King get 10 nuggets for like $1.50.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not eating that ever. Like, I don't know.
I've had that drunk.
It's not good. Yeah, I was going to say, it doesn't sound good at all.
It's never good. fast food. Let's be honest with you, fast food. I made my own. That reminds me. I was watching this online video and somebody was talking about chicken tenders, like being a chicken tender connoisseur.
Oh, I love chicken tenders.
Was it Report of the Week?
No.
I love Report of the Week.
It was like in a joking fashion, and I was like, man, I really want some good chicken tenders now.
Oh yeah.
Yep. So
yeah,
absolutely. I went out and I bought a bunch of chicken breasts and I chopped them up into tender shape. And I made my own like mix and I triple dipped them motherfuckers. And I fried them motherfuckers up, and they were delicious. And they were also—I'm pretty sure I had a heart attack because I triple dipped that shit. I was like, "This is the most gross shit that I ever could possibly eat."
That's when you know it's not good. But you know,
it was delicious. It wasn't like I'm indulging in like some fast food delicious.
Right.
I know this is good. The shit, the thing's moving. Yeah, I was like, I know this is really bad for me. Like, but also it's fucking great.
You know, you're having a stroke when it's like, does anyone else smell sulfur?
I put Old Bay salt, pepper, paprika, garlic salt or garlic powder, and a couple other things into the dry mix. And then I also seasoned the raw chicken, and then I seasoned the wet mix. I'm good. I'm good.
Give it a shot.
And I seasoned it every step of the way, so everything was real nice and seasoned. I was very happy with it. Nice and nice. It was also very fucking gross.
No, look,
I feel like it's that kind of thing that you make and then you're like, why did I do this? Why did I do this once to
again,
my body?
Once again, I can feel my arteries clogging.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what's going on.
They're great. You would love them.
I smell sulfur.
Yeah, I probably would.
Yeah.
And I can taste metal in my mouth. That's what you know.
You do smell? Like right now?
No.
My left arm just went numb, you guys.
You guys ever just get like a little pinch in your heart that you can't get rid of for a second? But I'm actually not.
The left side of your body just like kind of like.
Yeah. Hey, that's why we have stem cells.
Yeah.
They're actually really like apparently like destructive too.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah. What do you mean?
Like not as much as like.
Cancer.
Well, yeah. Or like. Yeah. Well, that's essentially what it does is like. They have to learn how to control it so it doesn't give you cancer.
Oh wow!
because they like grow rapidly. So
holy crap, this is hard, man. What the hell?
Picked the harder.
Why not pick extreme? I'm an idiot.
Yeah, it pretty much told you right in the name.
Right in the name, yeah.
Did it say extreme?
Is it extreme?
It's
extreme.
Literally called extreme. I think after extreme is survival. Fuck.
I think you got to get them all. Nope.
No.
I just want to get off this level now.
Well, you got another 4 minutes and 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Or you die, which will probably happen first.
Yeah, it'll probably happen first. It's so fucking extreme!
So fucking extreme. Peach.
No, I know it's not fun to make fun of people having strokes, but...
No, it's fine.
Yeah. I always find it...
I just made a whole left side of the body.
I feel like we've made worse jokes already.
Oh, no, absolutely. Well, you know, the only reason why I find it strange, because, like, the biggest thing about when people have strokes is, like, well, why don't you just take care of your body? And you know, this is... I drank for 30 years of my own life, and I'm 30. Don't tell me I live my life now. Well, it's like, already too late.
Came out of the womb.
With strokes, it's not even necessarily, like, it's just something that happens sometimes, you know?
Hormonal imbalance. Like, oh, who knows?
Or I'm pretty sure like it can be caused by like blood clots and shit like that.
Yeah, it can.
So like there's nothing you can do about blood clots a lot of times. Like you'd be a perfectly healthy person to have a blood clot.
Blood clot, yeah.
So, I mean,
you know what helps thin out your blood?
Alcohol.
Yeah.
It's a great way to
thin out your blood. I don't think it prevents strokes, but.
I'm probably
you're not a doctor though.
I'm not a licensed doctor.
So don't
however,
go telling people.
Yeah,
not
this
doing.
Is what this. You hey, what? You don't do yeah. this. Is that no? You're not licensed.
Yeah, you know what?
I didn't see you on Grey's Anatomy. True. So
they're not licensed either, man. That's not real doctors.
Are you what? Sure?
Grey's Anatomy's not real doctors, you guys.
No, they are.
I don't know.
Nope, they are.
I don't know.
Why would they lie?
Yeah,
it's Scrubs. Is Scrubs real, doctor?
Scrubs is real.
Yeah.
Scrubs is very real.
That's why it's not
funny. Apparently, Scrubs is actually more accurate than a lot of other shows.
Even House. House is very accurate.
Yeah.
House
is not a real doctor either.
Yes, he is.
House isn't even American.
There are doctors in other countries, Bear.
Yeah, but he has an American accent, dog.
He does that to make people feel more comfortable around him. Oh, is that what it is?
I know for a fact that House taught me if I pop the Vicodin, I can cure anybody.
That's if true. You pop fucking...
I can cure anyone in anyone.
It taught me if I get addicted to painkillers, that I'll be good.
I'll be fine.
I'll be an amazing doctor, and it'll never be lupus.
Never.
Nope.
Never. Sir, my organs are bleeding. No, they're not.
No. Do you guys ever watch Becker? Becker was like a precursor to... You should, no, Bear.
I've watched Becker. Yeah, Ted Danson?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, wait. No, I've heard of it. Okay. Yeah. No, you said Ted Danson.
He's so angry.
Yeah. Is he?
He told a pregnant woman to jump out a window.
Good.
Yeah, he told a fat guy with heart disease that he should exercise, and he took him to the gym, and then that fat guy had a heart attack.
Holy shit.
At the gym.
That show was all right.
That's a great show. It's a great American show.
It was pretty good. It was one of those Cheers spinoffs, I feel like.
Oh, okay. Where he probably still has Cheers money.
Oh, yeah. He doesn't have to work again.
Yeah, he doesn't have to. Well, all those guys.
Yeah.
Yeah.
George Wendt.
Yeah. Wasn't Woody Harrelson in it?
Yeah.
Yeah, Woody Harrelson.
For a while. Yeah. Not originally, but he came in later. He was in there later. He was a farm boy.
Was he?
Yeah, he moved from like Indiana or some shit. And
okay. I didn't watch Cheers. I didn't really.
You should
care
watch
for it.
Cheers.
I didn't care for it.
Should also watch Frasier.
I didn't care for Frasier either.
To be fair, Frasier is also a very white person sitcom.
Yeah, like, but it's also really
like
good.
It is the whitest of white person sitcoms.
I don't know, man. He likes Seinfeld.
I love Seinfeld, but Seinfeld's
pretty white.
It's very dry though.
Yeah, it's well. So is dude. If you want dry, like, Frasier really is dry. Like the definition of dry.
You know the one I could never watch? What's that one with that chick with the annoying laugh?
Fucking The Nanny.
Yeah,
that's because it was bad.
Yeah,
it's
a bad God, show.
No, I will never watch that show ever.
Fran Drescher is her name. Fran Drescher.
That's actually pretty good.
Yeah, it was a pretty good Fran Drescher. Also, Peter Griffin.
Yeah.
Same person.
Pretty pretty much the same person. Did you know that Fran Drescher and Peter Griffin are the same person?
Both from Quahog?
Yeah. Both from Quahog, both voiced by
Seth MacFarlane.
Seth MacFarlane, yeah.
Wow. He's been a woman this long?
Yeah. No, he's just voiced one, though.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah.
Alex Borstein is great as Lois Griffin.
She was on Mad TV.
She was.
Yeah, she is.
She was
Miss Swan.
Yeah, Miss Swan.
Yeah.
She was Miss Swan.
He looking like a man.
Which you would think that it would be some they would go like the obvious route and make Bobby Lee Miss Swan.
Yeah.
But no. Miss Alex Borstein.
That wouldn't have been as funny though.
It wouldn't have been as funny.
Alex Borstein was so good as Miss Swan.
God, what happened to Mad TV?
They ran it back.
It fell so fast. It was never good. No, it wasn't. There was like two seasons that was like really good.
There was like a couple of...
They're bringing it back.
Yeah, there was like a couple of really, really funny and memorable like sketches.
Yeah.
But like the majority of that shit was garbage.
Oh, no, it was garbage. No, I agree.
Well, that's true of like most sketch comedy shows.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like Saturday Night Live, even its bad years... I feel like most of Mad TV did.
Remember the best ones and just totally forget that a bunch of them were terrible.
No, like, I remember a lot of the terrible ones too. But
sadly enough, I watch SNL.
I do too.
Not anymore. I watched it by accident.
I love SNL. I don't care.
But was it Andy Samberg when he was there?
Yeah.
It was really good.
Samberg was fucking carrying that place.
He was a genius. For a while. And after he left, it's like, I don't really care anymore.
Well, Samberg left after, who's it? Forte had already left, right?
Yeah, Chris Kattan left.
Oh, Chris Kattan.
Chris
Kattan.
The guy that was in the We Are the Millers, that guy.
Jason Sudeikis.
Thank you.
Yeah,
he had already left by the time Sandberg left, right?
Did he?
I think so.
I thought he was in there a couple times. And he
was there a little bit.
It might have been a crossover.
Yeah, probably was. And there's another guy, I can't remember his name.
Yeah, they both still come back all the time.
But he plays. I don't remember. I'm drawing a blank. It'll come to me later.
Are you talking about the guy? What's his name? Oh, God. What is his name?
Are we talking about a character on SNL?
Yeah, he plays a character on SNL. But I'll probably look it up and be like, oh, it's
What's that guy's name? Oh, my God. How do I forget his name? I love him.
He played the angry politician. He was also in... Yeah, it's a lot of them.
All of the men.
Yeah. Daryl Hannah?
Daryl Hammond?
Or Hammond, yeah.
Daryl Hannah's a girl, I think. A lady, I think.
No. He's the guy who was the first KFC...
No, it's Daryl Hammond.
That's what I said.
No, you said Daryl Hannah at first.
Yeah, but then you corrected me, and I said,
really quick. And then I was calling back to that to the first thing you said. Daryl Hannah's a lady, right?
Yeah, really quick, I think she is. Yeah.
What's up with these strange ass KFC commercials? I don't watch TV much.
We just watched a bunch of them.
Is it so many different
Colonels?
That's
the joke.
Yeah,
New McDonald. Oh, is that the joke?
The joke is that like every few months they just replace them, and that. That
we were talking about Norm Macdonald and how Norm Macdonald was a good one.
Yeah, yeah. But now it's the new guy. He was in...
Rob Riggle.
Thank you, Rob Riggle.
Rob Riggle is the... He replaced the Krispy Kreme?
Yeah, he's...
They're running them concurrent.
Oh, really?
Because they're, they're advertising two different things.
Yeah. He's like Rob Riggle. Was it Riddle or Riggle?
Riggle.
Yeah, he's really funny.
Yeah, he's
really fucking
The whole
funny.
Joke
he's,
is that like... He's everyone's pretending
funny.
To
yeah,
be the
he's
Colonel.
He's definitely intense funny.
But nobody's the Colonel.
Yeah.
Oh.
That's the old
joke.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kind of reminds me of that Japanese team. Was it the, I was about to say Hiroshima. That's awful. So the something Tigers. There's a Japanese baseball team, something Tigers. Can't remember the name of the city. But they all dress up as the Colonel.
Oh, they love
the
him
game.
Over there.
Yeah. They all dress up as the Colonel.
No,
for
you
the
know,
game.
He's
yeah.
like Santa over there, right?
Yes. It's crazy.
Really?
Apparently,
yeah.
there was some, it's
oh,
the curse,
shit.
No,
the
it's,
curse of the Colonel.
Is it in Japan?
Yeah.
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 Like, I have a picture of me outside of a KFC.
Why?
Yeah.
Why did I say I don't know if I can go to Japan with you? We should go to Japan.
I think it's like the Hickory. Something.
Legitimately Hawaii? Because of
Hold
that.
Hawaii Tigers? That was just. Well, it's like the curse of the Colonel. Apparently, they lost some important game or something like that. They lost a game because the Colonel showed up. Now it became a thing and everyone just said it's the Colonel.
Hanshin
Tigers. Hanshin
Tigers,
yeah. We were talking about it at work yesterday and I was like, this is the greatest thing. I've ever seen in my life.
No, like, I have a picture of me standing outside of a KFC when I went there with a colonel dressed as Santa Claus.
Yeah.
You have it on your phone?
I can pull it up.
Okay, so that's fine. We'll put it somewhere.
As a thumbnail?
Yeah. We'll put it somewhere. Yeah, that's definitely going in this thumbnail. But
no,
the
it's...
We'll put it somewhere where so I can... we can see
no, it's... So here's the story about KFC and why people in Japan love it.
Yeah.
They equate it with Christmas because... During World War II, KFC was the only American fast food joint there. So on Christmas, the American soldiers would go to KFC because it reminded them of home.
Do you mean after World War II?
No, like...
During the occupation?
Oh, wow.
I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Yeah, during the occupation, that makes sense because we didn't have anybody on the mainland until after the occupation.
The occupation.
Yeah.
It must
because that was for a long fucking time.
Yeah. So... I think that the Japanese people thought that it was like a tradition in America to go to KFC on Christmas. So now, like, you have to book ahead.
Are you serious?
On Christmas to go to KFC.
Because of American GIs that went to KFC
yeah.
on Christmas because they thought...
Yeah,
they
I looked it up because I went there and I was like, oh, well, I guess they just think he kind of looks like Santa.
I mean, he kind of does.
Yeah, I thought that was like their logic. Like, this guy kind of looks like Santa. Let's dress him up like Santa.
Like Japanese tourists are like that is one thing I'm afraid of when I eventually do go there is because I'm a big fat white guy. Like I'm 6 feet tall,
yeah.
So I'm taller than most of the people there. I'm fat,
yeah,
and I'm very obviously insanely white. So I'm afraid people are going to be like, oh my god, can I get a selfie or something like that with you? Because like I am the quintessential, like I'm American.
Yeah, they're not going to do that.
Okay, good.
They don't really...
Even teenagers?
No, they don't really deal with other people very much.
That's
they kind
great.
Of keep to themselves a lot.
Oh, I want
to
live in Japan.
It's very nice. It's very refreshing.
Actually, England does the same kind of thing, actually.
I want to go to some type of
like
country.
This,
shit.
Where people don't talk to you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I get it every day, man. You guys see it. I get the shit every day.
Yeah, in downtown Baltimore, it's like too. Like even me, like where I don't know nearly as many people as you do, but being in downtown Baltimore, it's like
it's not stopping.
People
man.
Just talk to you. They constantly fucking talk
shit.
To you. And
little shit.
It is.
Yeah, like
it's
most
really
people
annoying.
Wouldn't even acknowledge you on the
okay,
street.
Cool.
At least they didn't me, or anybody.
But
I was
to be
with.
Fair, you're also.
But
not
I also
super
went
tall
with like,
and skinny.
Right.
See, but I also went with, like, a dude who was tan, about 6 inches taller than me, with, like, a ponytail.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Who, he blatantly looked like a white guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, on if purpose? We were to, I mean, I don't think on purpose. I don't think he went out of his way. But, I mean, like.
You know what? I really want to look like this tan, weird white guy.
But, if we.
Oh, there we go.
the same worry would have been there with him as with you.
Okay.
And nothing happened.
All right. That would be the only thing like that would like embarrass me. Look, this fat American.
The only person who talked to me on the street the entire time I was there was a nice girl who could tell I did not know where I was going on the train.
Nice.
Oh, that's great.
And she
Here the train is like the big thing over there.
It's great.
Don't they just stuff themselves everywhere? Don't they stuff everything in there? Like not like China style, but like.
I mean, it wasn't that bad.
It's not. It's nuts to butts, isn't it?
Not when I was there, really.
Oh, really? That's great. I mean,
I'm sure there was like we also probably didn't travel during like rush hour.
That makes sense.
So that you're on vacation,
so you're not really probably wanting.
Yeah, we were. Well, my sleep was all fucked up.
Oh yeah.
Like I would go to bed for like 3 hours and then just go out and walk the streets. Well, because I couldn't sleep.
I was supposed to say, at least keep yourself busy.
Yeah.
Well, Tokyo doesn't is like one of the like the I guess quote unquote Eastern version of like. Were you in Tokyo?
Yeah.
Yeah. From what I can tell is like kind of like the Eastern version of like the city that never sleeps kind of thing. Right?
Really?
Yeah. Like, there's I mean, like everything's a lot of shit to do. Like we we were right down the street from oh god I can't remember the name but essentially it was like their.
Main
night.
City.
Yeah. Well, no, it was like their night.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Like their night neighborhood where everybody was hanging out and a bunch of bars. There was like a Dragon Quest bar.
Really?
That's fucking cool.
Yeah, it's not there anymore. It was one of those pop-up bars. But
what the?
Now I'm just sad. You got to get the front of him.
But yeah, it was neat, man. I want to go back. Yeah. So bad.
Touch his front end. There you go. Yeah, I mean, it sounds like a lot of fun, and a huge departure from what. You know, we're used to American cities, which is cool. Also, like the focus on like. Also, I'm built for it because I've got not built for it. I'm not built for it. I'm prepared because I have both major handheld gaming platforms that I own. Unlike most people,
it gives you something to do
that are none. I also have iOS.
You can
so I have
connect
an iPhone.
With them. You can be better together.
I mean, I can connect with them via Street Pass.
Very true. I would assume it's probably like you get 1,000.
Oh yeah,
hundreds of people
carry.
Yeah,
which you'll get one every like even walking around downtown in a major American city, you'll get one every like
couple steps
weeks.
See, my biggest thing is,
dude, when I was traveling in DC, I would on public transportation. I got like for like 3 months, I got like four.
Yeah, it's
street pass. It was like nothing.
People just don't use it that way around here.
Yeah,
I want to go to Japan. I mainly want to go to Europe first.
Yeah, Europe would be cool.
I want to get high off brownies. Legally. I didn't say that.
All right. That's going to, I think, do it this week.
Yeah.
For this week's Infinite Pixels.
Yep.
Infinite Pixels plays. We played Pac Man Championship Edition. That's and a great again, game, my guests were
Zach
and
Kenny.
Oh, Kenny, that's sensual. Sensual. Ladies, Kenny is looking for one of you.
No, man, not today.
No, he's not. He's actually going out with a nice lady and her mom tonight.
I am.
So, what? Are you in like an hour? We gotta get back over there, don't we?
Well, yeah, I'm definitely going to those games tonight. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. All right. Cool. Check out our other episodes. You'll be able to see them on our channel at youtube.com/jetpackjoust. And some other cool Jetpack Joust content at jetpackjoust.com. Follow us on Twitter at Jetpack Joust. And I'll have the rest of our Twitter names on top of us here.
I do interact with people on Twitter.
I interact with it. I'm very active on Twitter. Zach doesn't do shit on Twitter. Yeah,
I'll tweet you.
So Zach is going to have access. Zach has access to our...
If you got a question, maybe just ask Bear, and then he'll relay it.
Yeah.
And no, probably
Zach has will have access to our Jetpack Joust Twitter, like the main Twitter. So if you have a question, you can ask him there. And if he doesn't pay attention to it, somebody will tell him to go to fucking Twitter and answer the.
Just come
question.
Find me wherever.
Yeah, just come physically find Zach.
Yeah, that's the way I like to communicate.
Except it's mostly in his basement, so
that's fine.
Don't come to my house.
Don't fucking come.
Just like try and find me at like I don't know.
When you're not in your basement.
Yeah. Somewhere where maybe I'm...
Don't come to my house either, though.
No, come to Bear's house.
You can come to my house. You can find me outside your local public library dumpster. That's where I hang out a lot.
Eating books and shit.
Yeah. Eating books?
Eating books, man.
What else are you going to eat in a dumpster at a library?
Knowledge is the key, goddammit, Bear.
Yep, that's how you get knowledge. You eat books.
You eat the goddamn book.
Like a big dumb bear doesn't know you're supposed to eat books.
Big dumb bear. I think you guys are confusing eating with reading.
Nope.
It's all the same.
Yeah. Same vowel sound.
It's all the same.
Same vowel sound.
It's all the same.
No, you'd eat the books.
I'm going to eat the goddamn. There's nothing you're going to do about this.
Yeah, yeah, I've got all these delicious books behind you.
So. Yeah. Oh, I've seen.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yep.
What is this?
Cook them up, right?
Is this Java for Dummies? Oh.
Bye. Fucking Jeff.